we shall discuss the comprehensive approach, right? And which is completely exam oriented. So first of all, before I move further, I would like to know from you, what are the issues that you people are facing in the current affairs? Then we shall start the discussion, right? So what are the exact pain points? What are the problems, the issues that you people are facing? Please type in the chat box, or you can tell me right now.
How to consolidate from various sources.
Okay, how to? Yeah.
Consolidate content from various sources. It's like newspaper, monthly magazine, current affairs, classics, yearly compilations, and all that.
Okay, how to consolidate? Multiple sources, which include daily current affairs.
Yes, newspaper.
Yeah, newspaper basically, and
monthly
and
current affairs classes.
And if you are taking any classes, then that class as well.
Yearly compilation.
Yearly compilation. Okay, fine. What else? Exactly, what are the minimum resources to follow? Okay, Chandan. Minimum resources. How revision books? Okay, how to revise basically. Nazmul, relevancy of current affairs topic, how can we decide that? Okay, relevance of current affairs, understand trends and prelims. Should I make notes? Okay, reading newspaper. Then making notes, how to make, should I make or not, and how to link dynamic and static part. Okay, UPSC is not anymore asking from the mainstream current affairs, how to go about it. Okay, basically how to go about, you know, less non current affairs, I can say, or peripheral current affairs. Very good. Which news is relevant and which is not? How to decide? Okay, connecting with the static part. Then relevancy, okay, of news. Very good. How to connect with the answer writing? Very good. Shireen is very good question. Answer writing. Okay, what else? How to integrate static notes with the current affairs, Niharika. Okay, static notes. I have stated this point, plus integration in the notes. You have this question. Sources for current affairs to tackle prelims questions. Okay, sources. In fact, we have already spoken about it, the minimum sources. Okay, any question you have? Anything else? Okay, I think most of the issues that you people might be facing, we have covered in this 8 points, right? So I'll discuss each one of these, right? And apart from this as well, if you have any further questions, so I'll give you the time to ask those questions. In between, I will say that please don't put the chat again and again, because that will distract the other participants, right? So whenever you learn something new, we have a culture of bulb on moment, BOM, right? So that gives me an indication that you are not sleeping in the class, right? Otherwise, please don't ask any question when I am discussing the things. You can ask the question, I'll give you sufficient time in between as well, right? The next question is how to cover current affairs for 22 if not covered in monthly PDFs. Okay, how to cover the current affairs if not covered in monthly PDF? Very unique question. Means aapko kuch extra topic kaise cover karna hai. Okay. So we have got very good questions, and these are the practical issues. As an aspirant, you people are facing this problem, and I am completely aware about it. Right, so I'll definitely discuss each one of these. So first thing is how much relevant this current affairs is for the examination, right? So if we see the previous year trend, the recent trend, the relevancy, okay? So basically issues I have already listed down, whatever issues you have asked, if you see everything I have listed down, even before you asked. I know the problem that you people are facing, right? So this is the, like, this is the mindset of a coach, of a teacher, that he knows what is the problem that you people are facing. This is the list that I have already prepared. Apart from this, you have further asked more questions, right? So first of all, what all discussion will be having? Approach, right? Sources, newspaper, which pages to read, which not to read, how to prepare the notes from the current affairs, Yojana and Krukshetra, how to cover monthly compilation, India Yearbook, PIB, Yajasabha TV, jo question aapne nahi puche, wo bhi aapko main answer karne wala hu, right? The relevance of current affairs, prelims 40%, rather I will say more than 40%. Why? Because even the static questions that they are asking, they are also based upon the reference of the current affairs. The source of those questions is basically the current affairs, right? The issue is in news, that is why they are asking this question, right? Means 50% and interview major role, very, very important role. So it is the integral part of your life, right? Now, we shall focus on every aspect today, right? And first of all, current affairs is not equal to newspaper. That is clear to everyone, right? So it has two aspects. Number one, just by reading newspaper, your current affairs is not done. Number two, on the other side, completing newspaper is not necessary. Means UPSC is not saying newspaper is the syllabus. UPSC is giving its own syllabus in the prelims and mains both. So if you skip the newspaper, should not worry that I have done some major mistake. So newspaper is not the syllabus. It is a source to, you know, bring some issues which are in news. So you should not take the newspaper like Lakshmikant, like this is the, you know, Bible. Do not read end to end. You have to be very selective. Okay, I'll tell you how to go about it. Then another issue is that please don't follow the news. News is just for the purpose of reference. Follow the issue or the topic which is in news. So any news can be a reference point for the issue, right? So I'll give you some example. Let me pick up the newspaper of yesterday. Yeah, so I have this newspaper in my hand. I have two newspapers, Hindu and the Indian Express. So the top first news is jabs for 15 to 18 group from January 3, booster for seniors from January 10. Now tell me what are the issues which we need to prepare based upon this news. The news is about, you know, vaccine for the 15 to 18 group and for the senior, the booster for the seniors. So tell me which issues are there. So when you see this news, okay, you just see the first paragraph. Pradhan Mantri, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced on Saturday that teenagers in the 15 age group would be eligible for COVID-19 vaccination, and frontline and health workers and senior citizens above the age of 60 with the comorbidities would be eligible on the advice of doctors for what he termed as precaution or third dose. This is the entire summary of the article. This is the entire summary of the news, right? So now you should think what topics I can use this news, or what topic can be important because of this news. So tell me, type in the chat box, you can tell me. Okay, maybe, you know, about vaccine itself we can talk. Production, effectiveness,
research
and development in India. Okay, this is one topic. Then
health
infrastructure, very good. We can link with the health infrastructure, specifically in the COVID. We can talk about, you know, management of the third wave, precautionary measures, or we can even talk about senior citizen welfare. Like if there is a question, what are the government initiative for the senior citizen welfare, we can write this, right? Why should we only write about the government scheme? Even this is a government initiative which we do not write. health issues, health sector. Very good. So think about the issues, you know, immediately. And how will that happen? That will happen if you are mastering the syllabus. So the key, how to find the relevant news and how to use that news. What is the key? The key is the syllabus. How many of you have mastered the syllabus? Means I know that you have took a printout. Aapke room mein bhi hai, bahut sare logon ke. But how many of you exactly remember the word by word syllabus? And by the way, if you remember now, you are the champ. That will help you a lot in deciding which news to read, which not to read, and in interlinking the news to all the possible topics. Right? Yeah, effect of COVID on the demographic dividend in India. Yes, Sunam Raju. Role of local bodies. Yeah, SDG goals. Very good. This is the effort with respect to SDG goal. So always think, you know, don't go about this news in detail. Go about this particular interlinking. When I can interlink. So this is what I mean by issue versus news. Now, there are so many sources. Starting from Hindu to, you know, Indian Express to Yojana, Kurukshetra. Every source has some unique thing. We need to pick the gems from every important source. Right? How to do that? I will tell you. First, understand UPSC requirement. What is the best way out? Syllabus plus previous year questions. This is the, you know, aapki baisakhi honi chahiye. Aapki preparation ka GPS hona chahiye. Your GPS is these two things, right? Now, current sources. Ye sources hain, all of you know, right? Agar kuch logo ko nahi bhi bataya koi source, toh main aapko bata deta hoon ki India Yearbook bhi ek source hota hai, right? So you have to limit your sources first of all, right? Now, you have to go through the syllabus and the previous year question. And newspaper, only one. Please, do not follow two newspapers. Only if it is your third, fourth attempt, you are already bored about Hindu. Hindu leke pak chuke hain. Then you should pick up second newspaper. Otherwise, only one newspaper you should follow. Second newspaper, you can follow only selective editorial. And that too only if you find the time from your other preparation like prelims static part, GS static part, you know, mains static part, optional static part, your test series. If you are free and you have completed all the targets of all those things, then you should pick up the daily newspaper of second news and you can follow the second newspaper, right? Do not follow Economic Times. Chahe aapka economics optional, yeah, even if you are weak in the economy. Economic Times, Business Standard, regional newspaper, none of those, right? Advantages of reading newspaper, you already know, continuity provide karta hai, vocabulary improve karta hai, right? Now, vocabulary do not mean you have to master some English vocabulary. Here, the vocabulary basically means the keywords. Keywords which are relevant to the UPSC syllabus, not otherwise, okay? It gives you broader perspective, right? Very precise perspective. It is a source of comprehensive coverage, very authentic, and it is unbiased mostly, right? It helps in answer writing. I'll come to everything. Now, how to cover the daily current affairs? So daily current affairs mein, I will tell, please don't spend more than 1 hour because the input to output ratio is not that much. Input to output ratio is much better in the current affair monthly compilation. Because the news is settled, there is a proper background research and it is systematic. So input to output ratio is much better in the monthly current affairs. And don't wait for the yearly compilation. Yearly compilation, you know, they will come 2 or 3 months before the exam. By that time, you know, you should be done with 3, 4 or maybe 6 months of newspaper or, you know, monthly current affairs. Okay. Then I always tell that the time management should be done in a manner that you should utilize your high productivity time in the highly valuable things. So you should not start newspaper in your most productive time. So what is your most productive time? Some of you? Morning. Maybe some of you might wake up at 5 a.m. Maybe some of you wake up at 8 a.m. and you start your study. Some of you are the night birds, night owls. So whatever is your productive time, please do not give the time to the newspaper in the high productive time. Give it in the less productive time, because anyways it is a newspaper, it will automatically attract your attention, and you will not go through unnecessary things. If you are using in the highly productive time, then it will consume your good energy, which is not required. Okay. So don't cover the newspaper as a textbook. As I already told, this is not Lakshmikant, this is not NCERT. Don't cover it, you know, end to end. I will tell you where to stop, right? I will tell you. Differentiate between news and issue, and start with headlines. Suppose this is the newspaper. So in this newspaper, first go through the headline, glance. Okay, don't underestimate Congress in UP. Oh, this is useless. Cut it down immediately. Ek pen lena hai aapko, and you have to cut it down immediately, that next time you will not even look at it. 22 farmer unions form front to fight Punjab polls. Now you will think, how can I use it? Okay, pressure group converting into political party. What is the difference between pressure group and the political party? This is the question of mains examination, right? What is another question? Agriculture reforms, maybe, but that is the past issue. Okay, I think these are the two issues which you can look into. Then next is Delhi government to procure essential COVID drugs from open market. Not that much important. Now you will go to skip all these advertisements. जो state government के advertisement है बिल्कुल भूल जाइए. Classifieds बिल्कुल नहीं पढ़ना है. No need to tell. Matrimony अभी समय नहीं आया आपको पढ़ने का. Okay. Then you directly move to this news, page number 9 यहाँ पे. Now you will see unity is essential and collective responsibility. Prime Minister Modi recalls role of Sikh gurus who did not hesitate in safeguarding the nation. Now this is important, because there can be a question about the Sikh gurus from the medieval history. So maybe you can look into the medieval history book. So I suggest that for the medieval and ancient history, you can go through Lucent. Lucent is good source, or any other source. So you look into which Sikh gurus have been there, and what is their role, which is more important, and what is their contribution in the India or in their religion. So that can be important for the examination, right? Then you are moving page number 11. We have not finished our mission, but large patches of Ganga are clean. So this is about the national mission for clean Ganga. Now this is very important, because here it is the interview of the director general. You will go through the entire interview. You will read the question and you will read the answer. How you can use this, I will tell you very soon. Okay. So this is how you have to go. Okay. And in the bottom, there is poverty key factor in determining institutional delivery. Now this is also important. Now again, how to identify which is important and which is not important? The only best source is your syllabus and the PYQ. After that, you can recognize. Now there are boxes. You can see in this, there is a box, low coverage. Janani Suraksha Yojana coverage was 55%, 55.7%. Now what is Janani Suraksha Yojana? You have to know about this, the features of this Yojana. What is the best source? Go to Google. If there is a government website, go to that, or go to Wikipedia. Wikipedia mein the stuff about the index, jo index ke upar ka stuff hota hai, you can read that. Otherwise, if you are following some good daily current affair, they will already do the very good research about it. You do not need to make any research. So what you need to do is basically look at the headline. Is it important for the UPSC? Yes, you should mark this tick. If it is not important, then cut it down straight. No need to spend any time on that headline. In the headline, please read the first paragraph. In the first paragraph only, you will get the crux of the entire news. Plus, look into the boxes. Suppose this is a news, poverty key factor in determining institutional delivery. So this is a box. This is important. This will give you the data. This will give you the crux. Okay. So this box can be used, right? Fifteen minutes. You have to glance and you have to identify the relevant news and you have to cut down the irrelevant news, right? Do not make notes. Daily current affair, I do not suggest the notes. Never. Please do not make any notes on the daily current affairs. बिकॉज सी वाई यू नो वाई आई एम सेइंग दैट क्यों बोल रहा हूँ ऐसा मैं डू नॉट मेक एनी नोट्स वाई देर आर मल्टीपल रीजन्स नंबर वन Already research is being done by experts. जैसे कि like different institutions including us, we are doing the research. Our team is doing the research. Okay, so you should not do the research. You are not here for the research purpose. You are here to become the civil servant. So spend your time on the revision, practice MCQ and do the daily answer writing rather than doing your own research. What is another reason? Number two, the input output ratio is very poor. Number three, the news is still in the development phase. There are many newses which are in development phase. Okay. Suppose there is a crisis in some country, like Afghanistan crisis. So today, the news can be in the front page. Now it might look like very important, but maybe after 2 months, this news disappears. So after 2 months, what will be the importance of this 2 month development? You will write maybe in 2-3 lines. Okay, because of withdrawal of these forces, this organization come into picture, it is creating the threats. India can play the important role in this manner. It can pose the challenges to India in the form of, you know, cross-border terrorism, and you know, it can undo the effort of India in the Afghanistan development. This. So after 2 months, this issue will disappear and your notes will also be useless. So, you know, the news keep developing and over a period of time it settles down. Then if you look back, you will find that only few stuff is important. Not everything is important. So daily current affair, do not make the notes, right? Never make the notes. Yeah. So important pages of Hindu, I will share this PPT, right? So you can look into this front page, nations page, editorial page, world page, business, sports page, mein important wala, Commonwealth, Olympics, okay? No need to follow every single sport. You can use this kind of style, right? एकदम कट कर देना है ओके दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट नाउ दिस यू विल मार्क दिस टिक ओके सो दिस थिंग यू कैन यूज एडिटोरियल पेज इज इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेटली शुड ऑनलाइन गैम्बलिंग बी रेगुलेटेड इन इंडिया इंपॉर्टेंट ओपेड पेज वाला तो हेडलाइन हमेशा आपको फर्स्ट पढ़ना है देन यू रीड द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ इट हेल्प्स यू टेल द 5 W's ओके व्हाट व्हाई वेयर एंड एवरीथिंग लिंक विद द सिलेबस राइट एंड व्हाट नॉट टू रीड पॉलिटिकल न्यूज साइड कॉलम स्टेट्स पार्ट नॉर्थ साउथ ईस्ट पोलिटिकल पार्ट पेजेस सिटी पेजेस नो नीड टू फॉलो ओके नाउ हाउ टू यूज द करंट अफेयर फॉर द आंसर राइटिंग हाउ टू यूज द करंट अफेयर फॉर द आंसर राइटिंग इज इट क्लियर एवरी वन सो फार एनी क्वेश्चन नाउ आई एम गिविंग यू द टाइम टू आस्क द क्वेश्चन प्लीज आस्क योर क्वेश्चन इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन एनी क्वेश्चन एवरी वन Any question? Please show the previous slides. Sanjana, we will share this PPT in the Telegram channel. Okay. So jotting down only example and important data in notes is fine. Yes, you can do that. How to cover budget and economic survey? Shiny, I will come to that. Don't worry. Okay. Simran, okay, very good. I'll come to everything, okay? Economic survey, India yearbook, and everything. So how to use the current affair in the answer writing? How to make issue 360-degree dimension? Okay, Shrikant. Okay. So tell me, now you please tell me how you can use the current affair in the answer writing. Example में ओके वॉट एल्स केस स्टडी यू कैन पिकअप फ्रॉम देयर वेरी गुड Government schemes you can use.
In social justice.
Social justice, yes, you can use. Yes, very good, Vasundhara. Introduction mein, you can use this, right? In introduction, you can use this. Very good, right? So, in introduction, I discuss the introduction hacks, where I discuss different ways to write the introduction. 8 different types of introductions. So, there I discuss that we can write the introduction based upon the current affairs. So, this current affair can be in the form of some government scheme. It can be in the form of some event, any summit or something, any Supreme Court judgment, or maybe any controversy through some legislation like this age increase in marriages is debatable issue, right? This is one thing. Introduction may you can use this. You can start your answer with the current affairs. Okay. If you want to learn about different ways to introduce the answer, tomorrow we shall discuss this in the mains masterclass. Some of you have already attended, and those who have not attended, tomorrow 11 a.m. we have this mains masterclass where we shall discuss 8 different ways to write the introduction and other things as well. Okay. Then in the body, we can write what we can write in the body part. Maybe to justify any argument, we can use the current affairs. Specifically, if I say the current affairs, in the current affairs, basically, we can pick up some example, some case study, maybe some facts, important facts from any report or any government source. Okay, what else? Maybe we can pick up some keywords which we can use. So when you are reading daily current affair, you should look forward for the value addition part. You know, you should look into what can I pick from this news. Okay, what can I pick from this news? For example, if I talk about this news here, the total Janani Suraksha Yojana coverage in India was just 36%. This data I can use. Either I can use in the introduction part. The failure of the government schemes. Suppose in the governance there is a question about failure of the government schemes or about lack of effectiveness of the government schemes. So there I can start with this fact. Okay. Or maybe if I am writing about the healthcare sector. In the healthcare sector, I am talking about mother health, the maternal health issue, right? So there I can use this fact. Okay. Second news, the second fact is, among the states in the study, the share of institutional deliveries was highest in Odisha, Rajasthan and MP. Now, how can I use this? I can use this as a case study. So for the Janani Suraksha Yojana and for the maternal health, the Odisha stands as a case study. Odisha 86% coverage as against the coverage of just how much? 36% at the national level. Are you getting? So this becomes the case study. You know, case study aisa nahi likha hoga ki Hindu ne likha hua hai. Case study to be used in the UPSC mains examination paper 2, paper 3, paper 4. They will not do this. They will just tell the fact, and that you have to think, how can I use it? So this becomes a case study for the maternal health. This becomes the case study for the
woman empowerment.
Yes, very good. Right? So this is how you have to pick up, right? Okay. So next, in this part only, there's a interview. Interview of this DG of National Mission for Clean Ganga. Here they have given some facts, and let me see if I can find some good stuff here. Yeah, so I can't find any good stuff here. I mean, I don't find any keyword or any major fact. So, not a problem. I have second newspaper as well. but you should not follow. Here I look into some news. Yeah, ISRO defers launch of 3 Earth observation satellites. Now this is important from the prelims point of view, right? So you can learn about Earth observation satellites and the role of ISRO with respect to mains current affairs. Then page number 12, there is a news about e-shram registration. E-shram registration. Now this is the government initiative. You can use this in the current affairs, labor reforms, right? Labor welfare, right? Then there is a data about post-China crackdown, shift in global crypto mining trend. So here it is given the data about crypto, not important. And then we have forex reserve slide for fourth straight week. There is a news about foreign currency assets, you know, the composition of the forex reserves. Now this is important from the prelims. This can tell you, okay, these are the component of the foreign exchange reserves, the foreign currency assets, the gold, the SDR and the reserve tranche position. So you can go back to your economy basics and you can revise your economy basics. So this is how you have to read. Okay, body writing mein to justify or to oppose anything, basically whatever argument you are giving in favor or against, you can always use the example, case study, facts to support your view, right? Conclusion, again, in the conclusion also, you can use some case study, some role model, right, in the answer writing. Apart from this, the role of answer, the role of current affairs in the mains is very important, because here you can identify the issues. Because in the mains examination, the preparation is issue based, not news based, not micro topic based. So you can identify the important developing issues. For example, this news of 22 farm groups converting into the political party, this is the issue, and this is the issue in the GS paper 2, the political party versus the pressure group, the difference between two, and how the pressure group have been converting into the political party. Multiple example in the past, are they successful, is it justified? Okay, so this is how you can link with the mains issues. Okay, this kind of question can appear. Okay, I will show you more of this, right? Clear everyone? Any questions so far? How to prevent negativity while
reading newspaper? Means aisa ho jata hai ki sab bura bura hai,
sab
bura bura hi chal raha hai newspaper.
Yeah, very good. So just stick to your syllabus, because newspaper to definitely the trend of newspaper news is nowadays becoming very very pessimistic, right? Like there are hundreds of news about what is not happening, but only two news about what is happening, you know, what good is happening. So definitely that's a problem, right? But you should stick to your syllabus and link with it. Don't get emotionally attached with it, right? Even if you become IAS, you can't do much about it. I'm telling you in advance. So don't be optimistic that I'll become IAS and I will transform this country. Single person, you can do a lot of things, but you can change the entire nation, right? Yes, Niharika, you can do that in the monthly as well, sure. How to take notes from the compilation. Indumati, I'll come. Don't worry. I'll come. So now, systematically covering the current affairs. How to do that? Daily current affair, I told you, just read the news at a glance. Don't read the newspaper in detail. Maybe you can follow some daily current affairs if you have good source. At Diademy, we will provide a very good source from January 1st. You can follow that. In the Telegram channel, we will post this. Link with the previous year question. This is something which is very, very important and which can actually help you identify what to read, what not to read, and even how to read. I am giving you a demo, okay? So this is the new type of monthly notes which we are developing, right? This is the July 21 file, July 21 current affairs file, okay? So what we are doing is we are linking with the syllabus and we are linking with the previous question. So you can see, this is the first news of July 21. BharatNet project and the Universal Service Obligation Fund. This is the news from the PIB, right? Now in the prelims, we can find a question on this particular scheme. The features of this scheme, BharatNet, and the importance of this scheme, right? In the mains, we can use this in the Digital India, in Rural Urban Mission, Digital Literacy Program, and in the Financial Inclusion. If there is a question on any of these four topics, we can use this initiative as a example, maybe as a case study, maybe, you know, as a government initiative, right? So this is one thing, BharatNet project, how can we use it? So what we are doing is, this we are, you know, developing, you know, this work is going on the monthly current affair. We are providing a prelims connect and the mains connect, okay? Now, next topic. So we are providing the background, complete background also, like Universal Service Obligation Fund. See, nowadays, if you see the 2022 pattern, so 2021 pattern, the shortcut will not help. Many people are asking, sir, questions in the current affairs, they're not coming from the mainstream magazine. There are few famous magazine in the market. So the questions are not coming from there. Why they are not coming? I'm telling you the reasons. Normally, if you follow the daily current affair in detail, I know the monthly current affair will never go below 150 pages. If we are preparing the current affair in a systematic manner, suppose Universal Service Obligation Fund, there are 5-6 points we should know. If we are not aware about these points, maybe some question will come from this point and we will not know about this, like whether USOF has a statutory status or not. It has a statutory status and this act is giving the statutory status, right? Basically, the topic which was in news was BharatNet, not even this USOF. But BharatNet is very much linked with this USOF. We should know everything about USOF. This is a government initiative. We should know about it, right? So every feature we should know. If I just give you the notes of the BharatNet, it will not be sufficient for you. And even we have to draw a Lakshman Rekha. It's not that now, you know, for everything I will explain you what is Indian Telegraph Act. No, we do not need to go that much into detail that we will lose the track. We have to stop it. We have to stop and we have to draw a Lakshman Rekha. And that can be done by any expert team. You are an aspirant, you will come to that level after 5 or 6 years, right? So if you want to wait for 5 to 6 years to become expert, then you should wait. Otherwise, if you want to really become the civil servant, then you can use these current affairs, right? So now coming back, why you people are facing the problem that you are not getting the questions in the magazine, right? The average monthly current affair magazine cannot go below 150 pages. Ideally, it will be between 150 to 200 pages. But students, they feel psychologically very, very happy if the magazine is below 100 pages. Now try to connect. The institute is not giving you more than 100 pages, because if it gives you more than 100 pages, then you will not buy that material, because you will feel, nah yaar, bahut jyada diya hua hai. Or you will say, no, I will not be able to find the time to study. And you will go and you will buy less than 100 pages magazine. Now that magazine will definitely miss something out. So that is the problem. Are you getting? If we are covering the issue in a systematic form, it will take 150 or more pages. And it is worth, if the source is good. So in Diademy, we are covering 3 sources: Hindu, Indian Express, and PIB. These are very, very important sources. And the questions normally do not go beyond this if we go through the static part as well simultaneously. So So we are covering the static part as well here. Okay. So you have seen the demo here. Okay. Now, next topic. This is again the topic on PIB. I am showing you. We have to cover the PIB as well, right? Now, how to interlink with the current affairs with the PYQ? Okay. So basically, this work should be done by you. But now, we have started developing these notes for you people, right? Revamped distribution sector scheme. Now this scheme is there. How can we use in the mains? We can use the energy sector reforms. If there is a question about energy sector reforms, we can use this as a current affair. Example of PPP, because this scheme is run as a PPP initiative, right? Infrastructure reforms. If there is a overall question about the infrastructure reforms in India. DISCOM reforms. If there is a question about distribution company reforms. Are you getting? So these connection we can do, you know, based upon the previous question. Like this type of question can come and you can interlink with this, right? Prelims mein PM Kusum or Uday scheme you can read and you can follow and you can read this entire scheme. Now, if we see the previous question, this is the question of 2016. This is the question of 2016. Which has come in the form of Uday scheme. Now, from this scheme, what type of question you can expect? The demo is here, right? Either they will ask the features of this scheme, or maybe they can ask what is the purpose of this scheme. Like Uday scheme ka pucha hai, so easily you can find this is the B, point number B, okay? No. Energy, yeah, D, basically D, not B, D for Delhi. Okay, purpose kya hai? Power distribution companies ko reform karna, right? The purpose of Uday scheme. Now again, if you have the question of the previous year in front of you whenever you are reading the current affairs, fayda kya hota, tell me. Ek cheez to maine dekhi hai, one thing I have seen is whenever we see previous year question, our concentration multiplies. होता है ऐसा? If we are reading in isolation, you will think कि हाँ ठीक है, discuss करते रहे, कोई problem नहीं है, या पढ़ते-पढ़ते भी आप लोग खो जाते हैं. But if you see the moment you see the current previous year question, you become alert. Your concentration becomes high, right? Why? Because it is actually linked to the examination. So we are now interlinking with the previous year question, which the work that you should do for yourself. But we now we are our team is doing that on the monthly current affair, not on daily current affair, because daily may, you know, it will not be feasible for us. Next topic is AIM, iLEAP, Innovative Leadership for Entrepreneurial Agility and Profitability Initiative, again PIB. Prelims mein kaise connect karenge? It can ask about AIM, AIM, or in the mains it can ask about research and development. Okay, mains mein yahan pe we can initiate, we can write about startup sector reforms or research and development reforms, initiative of the that kind of. Now what kind of question can come here? See, 2019 question. Atal Innovation Mission is set up under which organization, which agency? This is second type of question which can come. Now here in this scheme, you will look into ki which organization is running this, right? So this is run by Niti Aayog. Even, you know, this AIM also. Are you getting? So this type of question are coming, you can identify. This work we are doing from the month of July onwards. So we will release the monthly current affair magazine from the month of July onwards in this format. It will increase the number of pages. It will increase. But will it be worthwhile? I am asking your suggestion. Is it worthwhile for you? We started this initiative 1 week ago only. Because, you know, I was thinking ki how to make it relevant, how to alert you that what kind of questions are coming. If you see this kind of question in front of you, you will be alert. And what we will be doing is we will be connecting the current affair of last 20 years फ्रॉम एवरी सब्जेक्ट राइट. मुझे लगता है उसके बाद में दिस विल बिकम योर बाइबल. यू कैन यूज दिस एज ए मेजर सोर्स बिकॉज इट विल हैव करंट अफेयर्स, इट विल हैव थ्री सोर्सेज, इट विल हैव योर स्टैटिक पार्ट, इट विल हैव योर प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. सो इट बिकम्स योर बाइबल राइट. Now, even we will put up the mains question. If there is a mains question which you can use this data, we will use that as well, right? So we are doing the reverse engineering. Rather than, you know, आप हम लोग क्या करते हैं अभी कि mains की test series में जाते हैं and then we think कि ये हमने कहाँ पढ़ा था. Now, on a daily basis or in this compilation, you will find कि where can we use this, so that in your answer writing in your test series, you can actually यू नो थिंक कि हाँ ये वहाँ पे मैंने पढ़ा था राइट. वो आपको याद रहेगा ओके. सो दिस इज अनदर न्यूज डिजिटल इंडिया हाउ द 6-year-old मिशन हैज टेकन ए लार्जली ऑफलाइन नेशन ऑनलाइन ओके. सो बेसिकली द अचीवमेंट्स ऑफ द डिजिटल इंडिया इनिशिएटिव. नाउ इफ यू सी 2018 क्वेश्चन यू नो आई फील वेरी वेरी हैप्पी. आई मीन फोर न्यूज एंड ऑल द फोर न्यूज हैविंग द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. PIB से कितने क्वेश्चन आते हैं राइट. एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस इज क्वेश्चन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज और आर मेन एम्स ऑफ डिजिटल इंडिया प्लान ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. अगेन द क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट द पर्पस एम. आइदर देर आस्किंग विच एजेंसी इज रनिंग और वट इज द पर्पस राइट. फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इंडियाज ऑन इंटरनेट कंपनीज लाइक चाइना नो. Establish a policy framework to encourage overseas multinational corporations that will collect big data to India within our national geographic boundaries. Connect many of our villages to the internet and bring Wi-Fi to many of our schools, public places and major tourist centers. Okay. So, इसमें आंसर क्या है आपका? Yeah, B for Bombay, right? So, like this type of question they are asking. Now, when you are reading this question, this news, you will be more alert. You will read every line in a very systematic manner. Okay? We'll make it more useful. So now, what are the achievements of Digital India? Now, this is the ready-made answer of your mains. Right? Ready-made hai? Achievements mein puchenge to, only thing you need to do is, you need to put the dimension. Because these are the points. You need to convert into economic benefit, social benefit, political benefit, administrative benefit, you know, other things. So you can push this into pastel approach, political, economic, social, technological, environmental and legislative. Pastel approach mein isko put kar dijiye all these points. Are you getting? Yeah, ye bhi hum karke dein aapko bataiye. Hum kar sakte hain isko. Shrikant, we will also be putting the mains questions, right? As you can see here. Ye dekhiye, questions, Digital India pe do questions aaye hain. Now, the emergence of fourth industrial revolution has initiated e-governance as an integral part of government. Actually, this is the question of the e-governance, right? Now, in this question, you can use the data from here. कि हाउ इट इज हेल्पिंग इन द ई गवर्नेंस. ग्राम पंचायत, देन मेघराज, व्हाट एल्स ई गवर्नेंस में हो क्या यूज हो रहा है. नेशनल सोयल हेल्थ कार्ड, ग्रामीण डिजिटल साक्षरता, फ्री ऑनलाइन कोर्सेस एंड माई गोव. सो यू कैन पिकअप ओके. निहारिका, व्हाट इज योर सजेशन? प्लीज डू इफ इट इज पॉसिबल. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली? पेस्टल अप्रोच ना. अच्छा है, ओके ओके. हाउ कैन द डिजिटल इंडिया प्रोग्राम हेल्प फार्मर्स टू इंप्रूव फ्रॉम प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड इनकम? व्हाट स्टेप्स हैज द गवर्नमेंट टेकन इन दिस रिगार्ड? नाउ डिजिटल इंडिया एंड द फार्म प्रोडक्टिविटी. नाउ गो बैक टू दिस न्यूज. यस, नाउ गो बैक टू दिस न्यूज कि कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन क्या हो सकता है इसका. Gram Panchayat, it will help the farm productivity because the Gram Panchayat can implement the schemes in much better way, right? Aur kya kar sakte hain isme? देन वी कैन
सॉइल
हेल्थ कार्ड में, यस, ग्रामीण डिजिटल साक्षरता अभियान में भी, ओके, आई थिंक दीज थ्री आर वेरी गुड. उसके अलावा अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस लैंड रिफॉर्म्स, मेघराज जो है ना इसमें, वो लैंड रिफॉर्म्स के बारे में, एक्चुअली दिस मेघराज इज अबाउट लैंड रिफॉर्म्स, क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग एंड देर आर मेनी लैंड रिफॉर्म्स इनिशिएटिव एज वेल. ठीक है, सो लैंड रिफॉर्म्स ऑल्सो वी कैन ब्रिंग थ्रू द डिजिटल इंडिया. आर यू गेटिंग? सो थिंक अबाउट लाइफ साइकिल अप्रोच ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. ओके, सोयल वी हैव टेकन, लैंड वी हैव टेकन, वाटर में क्या कर सकते हैं? मे बी वाटर सब्सिडी को कंट्रोल करने के लिए लिंक विद द आधार, आधार के लिए इसमें लिंक हमने दिया हुआ है. देन वॉट एल्स, सीड एंड यू नो फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी वी कैन कंट्रोल, दैट विल इंक्रीज द प्रोडक्टिविटी. या वेदर फोरकास्टिंग, वेरी गुड. सो थिंक इन द लाइफ साइकिल अप्रोच. नाउ योर थिंकिंग शुड स्टार्ट, ओके, दोज डायमेंशन विच वी हैव गिवन इन द मेंस मास्टर क्लास, यू शुड यूज दोज डायमेंशन, राइट? यू नो यू आर एक्चुअली डूइंग द आंसर राइटिंग इन दिस फैशन, दिस इज ए ऑन गोइंग वर्क, राइट? आफ्टर द इनपुट देन कम्स द योर हार्वेस्टिंग पार्ट. इरीगेशन में हाउ कैन वी यूज द डिजिटल इंडिया? इरीगेशन में कंट्रोल द वाटर सब्सिडी, राइट? फॉर पोस्ट हार्वेस्टिंग हाउ कैन वी यूज इन द ईनेम, यू नो मार्केटिंग में हम यूज कर सकते हैं, ईनेम इनिशिएटिव इज देयर, राइट? एंड गेटिंग द बेस्ट प्राइसेस फॉर द प्रोडक्ट थ्रू ईनेम, राइट? देन गेटिंग द यू नो एमएसपी थ्रू यू नो बैंक, राइट? सो हाउ कैन डिजिटल इंडिया प्रोग्राम हेल्प फार्मर्स टू इंप्रूव फार्म प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड इनकम? What steps has the government taken in this regard? I hope you are getting that we can write the answer to this type of question very, very easily, right? RBI's data localization policy, the Hindu ka hai, TH means the Hindu. We can connect with this policy and the data protection, data digital fraud, okay? I think question has come on the data protection in 19 or 20. Submission on the agricultural mechanization. Farm mechanization, doubling farmers' income, we can use this, okay? Now, Pradhanmantri Fasal Bima Yojana, PIB question, prelims mein, they can ask about crop insurance, mains mein, you can write in the initiative of crop insurance, price realization, farm income, issues in the agriculture and the agriculture credit. Now, this question has come in 2016, Pradhanmantri Fasal Bima Yojana. With reference to Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, consider the following statements. Under this scheme, farmers will have to pay a uniform premium of 2% for any crop they will cultivate in any season of the year. This scheme covers post-harvest losses arising out of... I mean, this question is coming there. Now, you can read this entire current affair and you can solve this question. Or you can think what else they can ask. Mains mein they have given this question. Given the vulnerability of Indian agriculture to vagaries of nature, discuss the need for crop insurance and the bring out the salient features of the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. 2016 question hai. Ye kaun sa question hai? 2016. How many of you remember in the prelims masterclass I discussed this thing that they are repeating the themes of prelims and mains? You remember this, that discussion? So this is the perfect example. Right? Now this is the question of the schemes feature and this is also the question of the schemes features. So if there is a question of prelims 21, the chances of maybe couple of question repeating in mains is there. It's a solid evidence aapko aur kya chahiye, right? Niharika, we will release this from the month of July 2021, right? Yeah, July 21. So, July 21 se hum aapko release karenge isko. Increased private sector investment for overall development food processing sector. So, this we can use in the food processing sector. We can use in the privatization also. We can use in the doubling farmers' income. We can use in agricultural wastage. We can use in agricultural reforms. We can use in the FPO. FPO bhi yahan pe diya hua hai. We can use in the SSG. Theek hai. Now you can see these multiple questions come in. year after year with respect to food processing sector, right? What are the challenges and opportunities of food processing sector in country? Can India, how can income of farmers be substantially increased by increasing food processing? Now tell me, can you solve this question? Even you can, you know, even if you can't solve this question just by reading this current affair, but you can be alert. Yeah, this kind of question are coming. Second question, policy with respect to food processing, right? Third question, about again this processing, food processing only. Means this is a repeated theme. So this gives you an idea that this is the core topic. 17 mein aaya, 19 mein aaya, 20 mein aaya. Very, very repeated topic, right? Ayushman Bharat. I mean, this is a long list. We can go on and on, right? Yahan pe you can see. Yeah. This Pragyata guidelines. Okay. Now, what kind of question they will ask? They can ask this type of question. Swayam, an initiative of Government of India is related to what? They can ask Pragyata guidelines are with respect to what? Digital education, digital healthcare, governance, or something else. Right? Or in 2020, they asked the question, how have digital initiatives in India contributed to the functioning of the education system in the country? This is one of the digital initiative in the education sector. Are you getting? You are getting the content for the mains answer writing, but you will not be able to connect unless you have this kind of interlinkage. How many of you think it is really, you know, transforming? It will increase the number of pages. Please be attentive. But it is worth doing, because the work that you should do, we are doing it for you. Right? See, इससे ज्यादा pinpointed preparation हमारी नहीं हो सकती. Right? Coming back. So daily current affair mein I told you how to go linking PYQ. Okay. Weekly revision, very, very important. Find a day in a week and please revise all the stuff. Please don't be in hurry to complete the syllabus. Syllabus completion do not guarantee selection. Right? But internalizing the concept, it can increase your chances, multiply your chances, right? Means you have to identify the issue and you have to link and you have to prepare 360 degree. Now, if we see, we have seen two, three topics. One is about the crop insurance, one is about the food processing. Now you should prepare the topic of food processing in the 360 degree manner. Because the content that we have given is not 360 degree, but you can actually follow the content in the 360 degree manner. Possible? How to do? You have to look into every aspect. Okay. How to do in the 360 degree manner, we have already discussed in the mains masterclass, which is again starting tomorrow 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. we are starting the mains masterclass, where we will discuss introduction, body, conclusion ideas and everything. So those of you who have not attended, please attend tomorrow, right? Monthly magazine. Now people are asking me, like you have asked me, what is the approach, overall approach, sources ka? Okay. So there is daily news, then there is monthly compilation, then there is yearly compilation, first of all tell me, what is the source of monthly compilation?
Daily news.
What is the source of yearly compilation? Monthly compilation, right? Now what I am asking you to do is focus on the monthly compilation. This is less input output ratio, daily news, Means just have a glance, be aware, I am not saying miss it out completely, but focus on the monthly current affair. Yearly compilation you can ignore completely. Yearly compilation किसके लिए होता है पता है? Those who are the working professionals, I will not say non-serious aspirant, but I will say who have lack of time, who have not prepared throughout the year. Are you getting? Yearly compilation is not for the serious aspirant. Yearly compilation for the serious aspirant is not of use, if not of no use, because you have already covered up in the monthly magazine, na? So why are you wasting your time? Why are you waiting for the month, you know, yearly compilation? Start with the current of monthly compilation, na? Yeah, other sources I will tell you how to cover. You got the answer? Daily newspaper, monthly compilation, yearly compilation. Now about the MCQ. Daily MCQ, monthly MCQ, and yearly MCQ. Not required. Yes, do this, not required. So what should be the ideal approach? Pick up one monthly magazine, suppose July 2021, revise it and then practice 100 MCQs based upon this, plus identify 10 to 15 mains topics which you need to prepare based upon this monthly magazine. This is the ultimate objective, na? We have to clear the prelims and mains, right? Okay, what is your another question? So first question I have answered, and the classes ka bhi aapne add kiya. So depends upon the classes, ki, you know, how, which type of classes you are attending. I don't know, right? So you have to look, ki, is the stuff very good in the class? Okay, class mein normally they will explain the background also, concept also. So you can use as a supplementary, hai na? Background plus concept. Mostly if you ask about the current affairs, so what can we do? We can basically discuss the concept behind any initiative or any current affairs, right? So maybe that can be relevant for you, right? Minimum resources, okay. Reading newspaper I have covered, notes I have covered. Notes banane koi zarurat nahi hai in the current affair, because that will be less input output ratio and you don't have the time. Better utilize this time in other places. Less non-current affairs, for this authentic sources required. We are covering in the monthly current affairs, and in the prelims masterclass I have shown you that there are 30 questions which have come from our current affairs. Should I show it again? Those of you did not attend, rather we will do, we will put up that PPT in the Telegram channel. You can see for our monthly magazine 30 questions are coming in the 2021 magazine. So it is not about me, it is about the authentic research. So rather than you doing the research, let the experts do the research for you, right? And why it is coming from us, why not from very popular magazine? Because they are covering in the 100 pages. We are covering in more than 100 pages. We are not taking shortcut. Static linkage and the notes. Static linkage, again, research karna hai aapko. You have to link with the previous question. The questions that I have shown to you, that is a very, very good source. Previous question, syllabus, everything it is done, right? Relevancy of news. Previous question and syllabus, answer writing, I have discussed each one of your queries, right? 100 MCQs per month. Indian Express mein, I'll post this, you can find if you are following the Indian Express. How to prepare notes? A4 sheet mein prepare karne notes. If you want to prepare the notes, prepare only for the mains perspective, not from the prelims perspective. Okay. PIB. Yes, mostly the news are overlapping, because jo bhi PIB mein aayega wo newspaper mein aayega. So you can use as the revision tool. Maybe monthly PIB compilation you can follow. Don't follow daily compilation of the PIB. Okay. It is more about government policy. I already told you that we will also be providing the daily current affair from 1st of January in that fashion. So you can follow that. Okay. We are now providing the monthly, but now we'll also provide daily. Okay. Where we'll cover three things: PIB, Express, and Hindu. Monthly current compilation you can use as a revision. And just read the index and try to revise. And only one magazine. Means suppose you get a magazine, so how you should do is basically, so you pick up the index pick up kijiye. Throughout the month you have already been covering the daily news. Now from the index try to recall ki what were the developments in Consumer Protection Act, what are the features, what were the developments, okay, who is administering this act, what is the purpose of this act, okay, then governance of states in India, what was the news about it. Means try to recall ki what exactly was the news. It will help you revise, and then you know, open the magazine and then see what exactly is the content over there. So this monthly magazine should be used for the revision as well. So best way to revise is once you have covered the daily news and once you have gone through the entire current affair magazine once, then next time you will pick up the index and try to revise from the index itself. Or you can pick up a pencil and in the, you know, short point, you can write the features which you are able to recall. Are you getting? So you have to do the smart work, not the hard work. MCQs, I told you, month end pe, only after covering monthly compilation. Some people, they will say ki, sir, pehle MCQ practice karenge, fir hum current affairs padenge. That is not the right approach. Unless you are aware about the concept, you will not be able to fully take the advantage of the MCQs. Maximum 100 MCQ per month is sufficient. Online mein, maximum one. Yojana mein, only follow the editor's desk. This page. Very, very important. Very good information. Very good language. Right? Apart from this, 2-3 article you can follow. Okay. Select the article. Government schemes are there. So you can follow the government schemes which are given over there. Okay. Government scheme ke naam yahan pe likhe hue hote hain. Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. So they will give some features which are very important. They can be important case studies sometimes in articles. Chief editor's desk, important articles, and the government schemes and the case studies. Four things from the Yojana monthly. Similarly, from the Krukshetra, editor's desk, very, very important. Means yearly compilation of editor's desk from two sources is very important, right? Government scheme, they can ask. So editorial and government schemes. India yearbook, not every chapter is important. Okay, not suggestible to read. Most boring book of the UPSC. Pure UPSC mein sabse zyada boring book agar hai, to aap ye book le aana. Right? Okay. So not suggested. So what we should do is we should follow selected chapters. Selected chapters mein, these are the selected chapters. Okay, we will share this PPT so you can take out the details from there. Okay. Rajya Sabha TV, yeah, don't follow Rajya Sabha TV. You know, earlier Rajya Sabha TV we used to follow for the interview preparation only. Till 2013 to Rajya Sabha TV tha hi nahi, I think. Usse pehle tha bhi to kisi ko pata bhi nahi tha. This is a marketing tool of some institutes who started promoting ki Rajya Sabha TV aapko dekhna chahiye. Isliye mai website pe aao, visitors badhao. Right? And now people are thinking ki from day one itself I have to watch the Rajya Sabha TV. Ab iska naam badal gaya hai na, Sansad TV. Haan. So don't follow Rajya Sabha TV, especially if you are in the first two attempts, right? Cover it only for the interview purpose. After you are free from the mains, pura ekdam khatam kar chuke mains ko, ekdam relax hai, kuch karne ke liye nahi hai, to Sansad TV open kar lijiye, right? And that too, there too only few selected programs. And try to think, you know, where can I use in the mains, you know, which kind of debate is going on, what are the opinion of the different groups, what is the style of speaking of the different experts, because retired bureaucrats, academicians, the politicians and very good professors, they are coming over there. So what is their speaking style? Pick up some point from their speaking style and try to emulate in the interview. That is the purpose of Rajya Sabha TV. Not to clear the prelims, right? बिग पिक्चर में आप यूज कर सकते हैं. मे बी जस्ट फॉर द आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ मेन टॉपिक यू कैन यूज दिस. AIR न्यूज, इफ यू हैव मोर टाइम अवेलेबल इन योर लाइफ, DNA यू कैन फॉलो, दिस इज गुड, राइट? बट इफ यू डोंट फॉलो, डोंट बी गिल्टी अबाउट इट, इट विल नॉट मेक मच डिफरेंस, राइट? टॉपिक लिस्ट फॉर मेन्स इसमें हो सकता है, नो नीड टू फॉलो डेली, राइट? इकोनॉमिक सर्वे वॉल्यूम 1 इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन बिकॉज दे आर आस्किंग द दे आर गिविंग द रिकमेंडेशन. वॉल्यूम 2 इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन. वॉल्यूम 2 प्रीलिम्स के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है, राइट? एंड या ओनली 2 इकोनॉमिक सर्वे आर लेस मोर देन सफिशियंट, राइट? बजट ओके, ये हम लोग दे देंगे आपको फ्री में, दे देंगे इकोनॉमिक सर्वे. एंड ये बजट में व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट ट्रेंड्स लाइक हेल्थ केयर एजुकेशन इज हेल्थ केयर एजुकेशन एक्सपेंडिचर इज इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग. फिस्कल डेफिसिट इज इट इंक्रीजिंग इन लास्ट 10 ईयर्स और इट इज यू नो स्ट्रेट डाउन और समथिंग लाइक दैट. एंड द न्यू गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स, व्हाट आर द न्यू गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट, राइट? हाउ मच ड्यूरेशन 22 के लिए, यू कैन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम जून 2021 करंट अफेयर्स, दिस इज मोर देन सफिशियंट. फॉर 2023 जनवरी 22 यू कैन स्टार्ट, ओके, दिस इज मोर देन सफिशियंट. आंसर राइटिंग दैट आई हैव टोल्ड यू, ओके. एनी क्वेरीज, फर्दर क्वेरीज? तो मैगजीन से कीजिए, जुलाई मंथ से जून मंथ से कर लीजिए. पिक अप द मैगजीन ऑफ जून मंथ एंड स्टार्ट. वी आर रिलीजिंग दिस फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई, जो ये लिंक टू द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. सो मे बी यू कैन वेट फॉर अ वीक और सो एंड यू कैन स्टार्ट आफ्टर दैट. नहीं, उसके नोट बनाने की जरूरत नहीं, अंडरलाइन कर लीजिए उसको, अंडरलाइन द कीवर्ड्स बिकॉज नोट्स मेकिंग विल किल योर टाइम. How to buy the monthly current affairs PDF? Chad, we will post the details on the Telegram channel. We are actually launching a current affairs program. Current affairs program we are starting from I think this weekend or next weekend. So we will provide in that program. Otherwise, in the like for the PDF only, we will start some initiative and we will provide the details on the Telegram channel. Okay? Yes, Niharika, you are right. Any other question? And from our monthly magazines, we have got more than 30 questions. And you can look into that, okay? Very, very good source of current affairs. I have already shared you in the previous masterclass. I can still show you again, those of you who are the new to this class. So current affairs mein mostly, if you see, actually hot topic is less preferred. Like last year, Atmanirbhar Bharat, all these were the hot topics. So from our magazine, you can see these questions. Even the static portion, na? If you see, I told you ki in the static portion as well, in the static questions as well, they are picking the background from the current affairs only, right? Yeah, so they are picking the background from the current affairs only. Like this this question on Hindu female school, this was in news April 2021, right? International Mother Language Day, the Hindu news of 23rd February. See, aapke jo sabse important current affairs honge, those will be from October 21 to April 22 for 22 attempt. These 6-7 months are very, very important. As you can see here also. October में देखिए, October से लेके April तक आपको खूब सारी news मिलेगी आपके जो सीधे question पूछ रहे हैं वो लोग. Government bond yield. This was an examination question in 2021. This is a static question, but this was in news. Exact constitutional status. This is the question from the polity. But we have covered up in the static portion of the monthly magazine, 27th November 2020. आप देख रहे हैं ना, अक्टूबर से लेके अप्रैल तक ही मोस्टली आपको न्यूज मिलेंगी, हमने डेट भी दी हुई है उसमें. World Test Championship, 24th January 2021. This was the pure current affair. Right to privacy, April 21 mein news tha. Now you will say ki this is not the current affairs, but this was in the news, right? That is why we can solve this question very easily. This is pure current affairs. SARS-CoV-2, ACE2. आप देखिए, नवंबर है ना, जून 21, अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स, ये तो उससे पहले भी न्यूज में था, बट हियर इट वॉज मोर प्रोमिनेंटली इन न्यूज. ऑगस्ट 21, ट्राइबल लैंग्वेज विद रेफरेंस टू इंडिया द टर्म्स दिस पर्टेन टू विच एक्टिविटी, सो दिस वॉज इन न्यूज. ऑगस्ट 21, ट्राइबल लैंग्वेज. ओके, सो दिस इज द स्टैटिक क्वेश्चन, लुक्स लाइक वेरी वेरी स्टैटिक क्वेश्चन, बट इन द न्यूज यू कैन सॉल्व फ्रॉम द न्यूज. The only authentic source can help you. This is the screenshot of our monthly magazine. Monthly magazine का screenshot है आपका. And this is the 2021 question. So it's not that questions जो है ना वो कहीं out of the box आ रहे हैं. Those people who are asking is how to go beyond monthly current affair magazine. If the monthly current affair magazine is authentic, if you are not compromising the preparation, you are not running behind 40-50 pages or 100 pages, then you don't need to follow more magazine, yaar. If you are trying to save your time by following less than 100 pages magazine, then you have to, you know, waste your years and years, right? Similarly, this question, it was purely current affairs, judicial custody question, right? Purely current affairs, Olympics ka, July 21, right? And this is a Telegram channel, hamare Telegram channel pe jahan pe padha hua hai, you can see. अगस्त 27 को वी आर पोस्टेड दिस जून एंड जुलाई मैगजीन. ट्राइक्लोसन वेरी मच इन न्यूज जुलाई 2021 में पीआईबी में था. ये वी हैव डन ए बैकग्राउंड एनालिसिस वेयर वी हैव गिवन दिस ट्राइक्लोसन. फोर रिवर्स मर्जिंग, नाउ दिस लुक्स लाइक ए स्टैटिक मैपिंग क्वेश्चन, बट एक्चुअली दिस इज फ्रॉम द करंट अफेयर्स. इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी न्यूज में था, इसलिए मार्च 21 में दिस बिकम्स द टॉपिक ऑफ करंट अफेयर. So those people who are saying कि static के ज़्यादा question पूछ रहे हैं, current affair कम है, तो ऐसा नहीं है. Static is based upon the current affairs. Again this question of the Hindu, vaccine वाला question था, RNA this recombinant DNA, right? Forest Rights Act, very much in news, very important topic for the UPSC, right? Sports and awards, it was clearly the repetition of the 2000 pre-2010 pattern. So we will also be integrating pre-2010 questions so that from the current affairs you can identify ki 2010 wale pattern se question aate hain to aise question ban sakte hain. Personality, rewards or sports. So even in the sports, rewards, personalities, we need to be objective. Now we will not prepare the clerical level of personality. I mean, now we want to go back to and start preparing the banking current affairs. वो करने की जरूरत नहीं है. देर वॉज अ ट्रेंड विच यूपीएससी वॉज फॉलोइंग बिफोर 2010. वी विल लिंक द मंथली करंट अफेयर विद दैट ट्रेंड सो दैट यू आर यू नो वेरी वेरी रेलिवेंट, राइट? या फाइन, एनी फर्दर क्वेश्चन?